With a couple of ports, though, moving towards 24/7 operations, you said that you were optimistic that the supply chain situation might improve by Christmas. How realistic is that?
I think you will see some improvement. You know, as I said, this wasn't created overnight. We've never lived through anything like this before. You know, a year and a half ago, governors, including myself, all around the country, we just shut down our economy. And now we have to turn it back up again. But there's no doubt that the action the president took yesterday by, you know, working with ports, keeping them open 24/7, it will have a positive effect. And we will start to see some, you know, slow incremental progress.
Can you explain what the core of this issue is with the supply chain? Is it a shortage of port workers, a shortage of truck drivers? A lot of people just aren't clear on exactly what's going on, why these ships are backing up in Long Beach and Houston and places like that.
Yeah, if this were a multiple choice test, I would choose D, all of the above. It's a worker shortage. It's a shortage of truck drivers. It's the fact that demand is really high right now. You know, people have been kind of stuck in their homes, not traveling. So they're spending money on things. You know, they're not spending money on vacations. They're spending money on buying goods. And so demand is high. A lot of factories closed during the pandemic. A lot of factory workers are still afraid to go back. So, you know, we have disruption in the supply. At the same time, demand is through the roof, and it's just coming together in this really complex mix. The bottom line is it's frustrating for Americans who see prices higher or lead times longer. But, you know, we're going to fix this. We are going to fix it. It's just, you know, going to take a little time.